So, Mr. C, I've always wanted to ask you this very important question. Who taught you how to play the piano?
I guess my mom at first, when I was maybe 3 or 4 years old. And then I got into a real music, a piano teacher. You know who was one of my first piano teachers? Was the mother of Cecil Azarcon.
Really?
Yes, Minda Azarcon. She's still alive and she lives in the West Coast.
I never knew that. There's so many things I read about you I didn't know, and I thought I knew you the best. Of all the singers, I thought I knew him the best. Because this show is like Ryan Musikahan without the Musikahan.
We can have this. That's absolutely.
There we go. Cue the music. Now tell us about your very first musical piece. What was your first ever?
One of the first songs I really learned how to play the piano was taught by my mom. And I don't know if that's the title. The lyrics were Me Gustan Todas. She taught it to me.
Disco song. Oh, there's no lyrics?
No, there's a song. There are lyrics. She sang.
She's an opera singer, right?
That is right. That's right. She sang. But she died when she was 43 years old, and she was just about,
Take off?
Take off as a real opera singer. She was training to be one, and then her first starring role as an in an opera was Aida by Giuseppe Verdi. And she did that in 1957 or 58. 1960, she was kaput.
So I guess you could say that your first musical influence was your mother.
That's true.
So opera was basically your foundation then, maybe?
Exactly. Or? Not only opera, art songs, Filipino kundimans, that was what was playing in the house. Mm-hmm. And every time there was somebody singing, playing, everything was classical music. Because we had 10 lady boarders in our house in UP. And all of them were music students.
Really?
So you can imagine every hour on the hour, somebody was playing or singing. You can't escape.
What was that song that played constantly? Just a little bit, if you can remember.
Well, it could be something like Mutian ng Pasig, which is like...
Your mom wasn't really that excited about you joining the business.
Not at all. As a matter of fact, when she died, when we were, I was 6 years old, she told our father in her deathbed and said, "Do not allow any of the children to have a career, to take up a career as a musician."
Musician. Really? Why?
In music.
Why?
Because she was a musician and she knew.
Well, look at how far you've gone from that to what they call a maestro.
It was a conscious effort to try to learn everything I could because, anyway, I love it.
Yeah.
Learning it was easy because it's something that I like. It's not like forcing it to myself.
Mm-hmm.
It was part of me already. So
to this day,
it's like
Mr. C, but to this day?
Yes.
It's never been work?
No, not at all. As a matter of fact, I look forward to it because right now it's a bit few and far between because I spend a lot more time now promoting younger people, teaching them how to write, teaching them how to arrange.
I've learned that about you. I mean, besides the fact that you took a business, I think that's one thing our mothers had in common. My mom was always against me becoming a singer. You know, man, musician, ako naman singer, starving singer kami sa Hawaii. But only because if all else fails, we have something to fall back on.
Yeah.
And you took up, was it accounting?
I took up accounting because we just followed my father's, advice, saying, none of you are going to take music. Anyway, it was very clear to us that we were not going to be musicians at the start. I took up accounting, but I was already working as a musician.
As a musician. So your parents were correct.
Yeah.
You became a musician, and now, to this day, we're always accounting on you.
Okay, fine.
Did you like that?